Please enjoy hundreds of my video lectures on telecom and wireless. Please do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Please also like my videos. Please share my channel with your friends and colleagues. Thank you.
In this line, we will look at 3G standards. Let's look at the animation. What is 3G and what are its objectives? 3G supports universal global roaming. That means, irrespective of where you are in the world, you will have a roaming facility and there is no need for separately subscribing to that. 3G supports multimedia, voice, data and video. 3G supports increased data rates, 384 kilobits per second while moving and 2 megabits per second when stationary at specific locations. 3G also supports increased content capacity, more efficient usage of frequency spectrum, more number of subscribers, etc. And 3G of course is an all IP structure. 3G partnership projects, 3GPP, has two distinct paths. 3GPP is a standard for GSM and 3GPP2 is a standard for CDMA. 3G standards mainly focus on evolution of access networks and core networks. Let's now look at the animation that's appearing. What's the purpose of 3GPP2? 3GPP2, as we said, deals with CDMA and 3GPP2 evolved frequency division duplex and time division duplex systems. What is FTD and TDD? Reader can refresh from his sources. The purpose of 3GPP2, it evolved a comprehensive global technical specifications for a 3G mobile system based on the evolving ANSI-41 core network and CDMA-2000 radio access technologies. We have seen ANSI-41 standards, though briefly, elsewhere. The next objective is these specifications support 3G networks based on both Internet Protocol and ANSI-41, including interoperability between these networks and the mobile station. 3GPP2 supports the ITU recommendations on interworking between IMT 2000 family members. Smooth evolution of CDMA 2000 from 2G to 3G while expanding 2.5G capabilities. That is, compatibility both upward and downward exists across all evolutions or all flavors of CDMA networks. Given IS-95 is a FDD, that is Frequency Division Duplex based technology, technical proposals were also introduced which defined TDD, Time Division Duplex modes of operation as well. Therefore, CDMA supports both FDD and TDD. 3GPP2 also supports many existing services such as speech coders, packet data, secure data, fax, SMS, over-the-air interfaces, etc. These features were of course available in IS-95 family and 3GPP2 made sure they were also included in CDMA 2000, which is a 3G version of CDMA. Let's now look at the new animation. The 3G standards for GSM based technology is evolved by 3GPP consortium. The 3G version of GSM technology is also called wideband CDMA and also is known as UMTS, Universal Mobile Telecommunication Services or Universal Mobile Telephony Services. We will have an overview of UMTS in this e-learning series of CDMA as the last chapter. In this slide, let us talk about what is a physical channel and what is a logical channel. Look at the figure. What's a physical channel? Physical channel is the one which is associated with frequency bands, time slots, codes, bits, bytes, modulation, error correction, etc. Physical channels transfer bits and bytes from one network element to another. Physical channels in CDMA are described in terms of a wideband RF channel and code sequence. As defined in CDMA 2000, each RF channel is 1.2288 megahertz wide. Each RF channel, there are 128 Walsh codes or Walsh sequences W0 to W127. These Walsh sequences are commonly referred to as CDMA code channel. What is a logical channel? The physical channels that carry specific types of information are known as logical channels. Logical channels are distinguished by the nature of carried information and the way to assemble bits into meaningful data units. Therefore, the physical channels, when they are converted into an assembly of meaningful data units, that becomes a logical channel. Logical channels in CDMA are divided into two categories, traffic channels and control channels. In general, for the forward link, there are three types of control and signaling channels and one traffic channel per user. Whereas for the reverse link, there is just one type of signaling channel and one traffic channel per user. Let us revisit this logical channel. What is logical channel? Logical channels are distinguished by the nature of carried information and the way to assemble bits into data units. For example, traffic channels and signaling channels are logical channels. There are three types of them. One-to-one example, traffic channels always between the base and one mobile. One-to-many example, a paging channel or a synchronization channel which is from base to all the mobiles in the cell. Many-to-one, access channels from several mobiles to a single base station. Let's look at this new figure. It is important to note that signals on the forward link are identified by Walsh codes. However, signals on the reverse link are identified by long codes. So the user separation in the forward link, please note, is by Walsh codes, and the user separation in the reverse link between various mobiles is by long codes. Let us look at interleaving in this slide. Look at the animation. A simple implementation is shown in this. Data is read row by row into an interleaver at the transmit end, read column by column out of the interleaver. This process is called interleaving and propagated after other modulation processes. The reverse exactly takes place at the receiver to recover the signal. Assume fast fading or a burst noise attack happens during the timing instance of bits 23 and 4 of row 2, which during reception results in error of these three bits. Case 1. Without interleaving, speaker 2's 3 bits would have been lost. Percentage of error is 3 out of 8. Case 2. With interleaving, speaker 2 would have lost 1 bit, that is his second bit. Speaker 3 would have lost 1 bit, that is his second bit. And speaker 4 would have lost 1 bit, that is his second bit. The error rate is 1 by 8 for each of these subscribers. This is the improvement in interleaving. Instead of one channel losing plenty of bits, the damage is distributed among many channels. Please note, interleaver does not increase or decrease bit rates. It requires store and forward buffers, which means there will be a transmission delay. What is transmission diversity? One more important term in CDMA technology. This is a new feature in CDMA 2000 that was not present in IS-95. Transmit diversity enables the base to transmit over two antennas in the forward link. All channels except for pilot, paging and sync channels are transmitted in this fashion. What is transmit diversity? This typically uses two transmitting antennas. Transmission through two antennas spaced several wavelengths apart achieve spatial diversity. This ensures that the two transmitter signals undergo independent fading and therefore are uncorrelated. The probability that both these signals will fade drastically simultaneously is very small. Let us look at the new figure that's appearing on your screen. CDMA 2000 deploys two transmit diversity schemes. One is orthogonal transmit diversity, uses two PN sequences I and Q that provide orthogonal transmit diversity. The next one is space time spreading. CDMA 2000 deploys two antennas as shown in the figure. Let us look at multi-carrier downlinks. The following figure illustrates the structure of downlink multi-carrier in CDMA 2000. It's very similar to the single carrier implementation. After scrambling, if applicable, the user data is demultiplexed to feed the N IQ modulators. N can be 3, 6, 9 or 12, so that each frequency carries part of the data stream. The N carriers are Walsh modulated to the chip rate of 1.2 to 88 megachips per second. The Walsh codes may be different to each other. As for the single carrier use, provision is made to puncture the data stream to add a bit for power control. This is also indicated by the bit selection box. The carriers are located on a different frequency with a spacing of 1.25 MHz between each of them. That is, three carriers are used for CDMA 2000 3X. Uplink. There is no multi-carrier implementation for the uplink connections. Please note, all the multi-carrier implementation is only in the downlink and not in the uplink. The block diagram is self-explanatory and the reader is advised to spend some time to look at this particular slide carefully.
Hi guys, hope you have enjoyed this video. Before you leave this, please ensure that you are subscribing to this. Also, please do like these videos and share it amongst your friends and colleagues. There are plenty of other videos and I hope you will be able to find time to browse through all these things. Thank you.